In this video, I'm going to share the one secret that I use to make my visual effects look super realistic. This is already the last video of my 6-part VFX training series. I hope you enjoyed it so far.
If you want access to all 6 videos, then click the link in the description below.
We've already taken a deep dive in the world of VFX to lay your foundation. We've also talked about the best computer your money can buy, which tools are the best for the job and most efficient. Heck, I even share the exact steps you need to take in order to create epic VFX every single time. I just wanted to stop for a second and say thank you so much for everyone who has seen the series. Your dedication is definitely gonna pay off. I've received a lot of emails and DMs on my Instagram about fellow creators that wanna up their game. And I can just tell you one thing, you're gonna love the bonus that is coming at the end of this video. Because as said before, VFX is hard, but it doesn't have to be if you know the exact steps you need to take. Alright, so now I'm going to show you the exact method on how I create super realistic looking visual effects in compositing. So once you have your entire VFX scene and you bring it in your compositing software, in my case After Effects, here you have to make everything blend together. So here the magic really happens. Say you have an export from 3D software, it always looks super clean. Your edges are ultra sharp, there is no noise whatsoever, everything is non-distorted, it's just a clean image. And that's a problem. So whenever you're creating VFX, the biggest problem the most beginners make is they make their 3D models too perfect. And in reality, nothing is perfect. If you would have a transformer robot, beginners would tend to make a clean robot. Clean chrome metals, clean car paint on top of the models, but that's actually not what makes it look realistic. In reality, these robots have fought wars and they actually got scratched, they got dirt on themselves, they got paint that is actually fading off, the sun was all the time on this paint, so it has some kind of color shifts maybe. You really have to think about all these things. This is already a big part that is going to help you get super realistic looking visual effects by just making them look not perfect. Whether you apply dirt to it or not, it's always going to look way too clean. And that's just because 3D software render your image super clean. And when you're recording with a camera, you always have the following issues, such as lens distortions, some chromatic aberrations at the edges of your camera. You might have some vignetting, you might have camera noise depending on the lights you have used. You might have some color shifts depending on the codec you have used. So all these things are things that you don't see on the 3D model. So now what is the big secret here? Well, it's really simple. You have to make your 3D look more shitty. So this process is actually called crapitization. So when you have your 3D integration and you place that on top of your original footage, you now want to apply all these different things that you see that is in the original footage. So what you want to do is add again a noise and grain in there. You want to match the exposure level, so that's the brightness of your footage and your 3D. And you can actually use the info panel here to check how black something is and how white something is and also how saturated something is. Oftentimes, I see beginning VFX artists use way too saturated 3D stuff in a very flat scene. So really match your colors. That's the number one goal here. Once you have matched your colors, you can apply the noise, you can apply some lens distortion, some chromatic aberration, and some vignetting on top of all of that. Maybe some edge blur, so I'm using a channel blur for that. And then finally, once you have done all that, it looks pretty good integrated on your original footage. And then on top of that, you want to apply a grade, which is going to grade the original footage, but also your VFX shot, and that's going to make everything blend better together. Alright, so that's basically a big secret in the VFX industry. A lot of people forget to crapitize their footage, they just export their 3D and they're good to go. But this will always look fake. Anyway, now that you know the exact method on how I achieve realistic looking visual effects, you've almost finished the 6-part training series to drastically improve your knowledge to create visual effects in the most efficient way possible. And even though that you know what it takes to create epic looking visual effects, this is just a start. The most important thing is to know where to start, because if you put in the time and get frustrated along the way, you're just gonna end up quitting. And that's something that I had to struggle with more than I wanted to. But if you are committed to this, you can create epic looking visual effects in a matter of weeks, and that without any prior knowledge or experience. I've said this a lot in this training series, VFX is hard, but it really doesn't have to be. So that's why I want to make the people that are very serious about visual effects a pretty insane offer to work together with me. And if you join within the next 5 days, I'll even throw some extra bonuses in there. Also, you won't need to spend thousands of dollars on software because we're actually collaborating with Maxon and Adobe. They also saw the value of this academy, so we made this amazing deal with them, which honestly is just a bonus on top of everything else. All right, thank you so much for watching. You can always reach out to me on Instagram if you have any questions, or send an email to hello@epicvfxacademy.com. Until next time, create epic videos.
If you want access to all 6 videos, then click the link in the description below.